Currently, you have a couple other fights on your hand right now, trying to, you know, climb up the pro league table a bit. This year too, it's a classic coming up as well. You know how you see things there?
Yeah, I think that though, as well as we have been doing all season, we're in a situation where it's very easy, should things go wrong now, to end up with nothing.
Yeah.
And that's where we are. I think the reality is that it would have been nice for the club if we could have sort of focused and channeled our resources in a particular aspect. So for example, the league. But our resources are stretched a little bit thin right now in terms of the players.
Mm-hmm.
So I think that is something that we have to manage very closely over the next couple of weeks, because there's a very real chance of player fatigue and player burnout. I mean, it's such an intense period now. I mean, as I say, every game is very important. So it taxes the players mentally and physically. And I think that's where we face our biggest challenge right now. Because as I said, our ambition is really to win the TT Pro League competition. But all the other competitions are important. And although you may say, well, you have a preference for one, the reality is that when the players get into it, everybody wants to play all the games and everybody wants to win all the competitions. So, that's a challenge. I mean, like on Friday, we're going to be playing for the third and fourth playoff. And, common sense suggests that we can take a different approach. You know, maybe play some of the younger players, some of the reserve team players. But as I said, I mean, it's difficult to hold back the players who into a winning mode right now.
Of course. You mentioned the obvious lack of resources and financial support for the club. That's no secret. How does the club benefit from, let's say, the export of players? One in particular, Denzel Tierwall, you know, he's doing pretty well in Hungary right now. Can you give us an idea as to how did the club really benefit, you know, with regards to Denzel, you know, going out there? Was there anything coming back to the club from that deal?
To be quite honest, the club, the arrangement that the club had with Denzel was not, I mean, given Denzel's status at the time, the club would not have had Denzel on a 2-year or 3-year kind of contract.
Mm-hmm.
That would have allowed us to get the best opportunity.
Yeah.
I think Denzel was on a month-to-month, and he had a particular type of arrangement with the club. So the club really would not have benefited, and maybe it should have, from Denzel going abroad, given the relationship that Denzel and the club have had for years. But as I said, that's one of the challenges the club faces, and I think that we have put things in place this year. We are going forward, obviously, that those types of things will not happen.
So obviously now we can expect, because one of your main ambitions must be, when you consider the state of our league and the state of leagues abroad and the business that is involved, one of your main ambitions must be to benefit from exporting players when they can move on to bigger things outside.
Yeah, very much so. I mean, that's as a matter of fact, when we did a sort of strategic plan when I came in, that's one of the key revenue streams that would have been identified for the club at this point. And that's why also, getting our youth development program back up and running is a critical part of what we're going to be doing going forward. But again, the reality is that you were saying that there are some financial challenges that the club, being a community-based club from the Mova Caledonia AIA, faces that we are struggling, to be honest, to overcome. I mean, we do get support from Dylan Massey and the sport company and some merchandising, but the reality is that it falls a bit short. But that's something we have to correct, because as you were saying, that there are a lot of opportunities and we have some good young players on the team. So even within the league itself, right now, as you know, that there is a sort of window opening coming in November, when you have to make sure that you secure the players that you want to have next year, and those who are not on long-term contracts, so that even that is a challenge. And I think, as I was telling Jamal, one of the disadvantages of how well the club would have done this season so far is that it actually going to mean that there are players who now would have been targeted by the other team. So, it's a challenge. I mean, professional football is not an easy business, and it's a challenge.
Yeah, of course. That is something. Does the club have any plans of, you know, trying to establish a more home-based sort of facility, where the community itself can come out and support the team? It doesn't have to be a massive stadium, but something where, you know, you can accommodate your fans?
Very much so, Sean. As a matter of fact, there have been some discussions taking place between the TT Pro League and the sport company with regard to grounds in the community. I know that from Caledonia's point of view, we have identified there are two grounds in our home community, which is the one behind the Russell Latterby High School, and then there is one down, if you pass the name, it's Dong and Hill. At this point, whichever grounds we could get and built up. I mean, as you said, it don't have to be anything massive. We want something that goes to 3,000 people.
Of course.
That's very, very important, because if we were to have a ground in the community, it would also help us financially, because we think that we can attract 2,000-3,000, 4,000 people at our home game, given the interest in the community for Caledonia AIA football.